गुड इवनिंग एंड आई वेलकम यू स्टूडेंट्स। वी आर गोइंग टू गिव ए रिविजन एज वेल एज सम इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द चैप्टर ऑफ केमिकल काइनेटिक्स। व्हाट वी आर डूइंग स्टूडेंट, इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस रिविजन फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री। And in this, we are talking of chemical kinetics, students. Chemical kinetics. Important points to note. What is a chemical kinetics, student? It is a study of the rates of the reaction. So, first important point, if I have a reaction, R is getting converted into product. What we define, student? What is the rate of a reaction? What do you mean by rate of a reaction? 30 seconds, student. Fast, be with me. Be with me.
The rate of the reaction is the speed of the reaction with which there is a change in concentration of reactant or product in unit time.
So you are saying minus of delta R by delta T. Delta R by delta T, student. Or plus delta P by delta T, that is change in concentration with time. What are the units of the rate of the reaction? Units. What are the units?
Mole per liter per second.
So concentration by time, mole per liter divided by second inverse. These are the units of the rate of the reaction, students. Why negative sign is given when we write the reactant?
Because the concentration of the reactants goes on decreasing with time.
Then what will happen if it goes on decreasing? It has to decrease. It has to decrease with the time because the reaction is taking place. The rate can never be negative. So that is the main point. Can the rate be negative? Can the... What do you mean by negative speed, student? So that is why we are doing it. So to make it positive, the rate of the reaction, what is happening? Concentration is decreasing. Then in order to make that positive, student, we delta R is negative. In order to make it positive, we put a negative sign because the rate of reaction is a positive quantity. But I'm saying rate of reaction is positive quantity, student. What is the point?
Yes, sir.
What we have to write, we know the things, but how to and what we have to write, we have to be careful. Important points. Something called average speed, student. Average rate and instantaneous rate. What is the difference between the two, student? This question was asked in the paper. What is the difference between average rate?
The average rate is the overall rate of the reaction. Whereas the instantaneous rate is the rate of a reaction at any particular instant of time.
What do you mean by average rate? Average rate is nothing but change in concentration over a period of time. Over a period of time, I'm saying. And instantaneous rate is at a particular instant of time. At a particular instant of time, students. We have to be careful of the words. That is my point. Why I am revising? Because you will know a lot of things, but you will not be able to write the correct answers in the exam, students, and marks will be lost without any reason. Marks will be lost without any reason. That is the point, students. So we have to be careful for any reaction like AA plus BB gives CC plus DD, student. What we write as rate minus 1 by A. Delta A by delta T is equal to minus 1 by B delta B by delta T, students, is equal to plus 1 by C delta C by delta T, students, is equal to plus 1 by D delta D by delta T, students. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So what is the minus delta A by delta T, student? What is the difference between minus delta A by delta T and minus 1 by A and delta A by delta T? What is the difference between these two, students? Question numerical will be there on that.
In the second case, 1 by A is the stoichiometric coefficient of the reaction.
That we know, we are already saying it is a stoichiometric coefficient. That's why we are divided. There will be numerical based on these students. It was asked 2 years back also. This is the rate, student, of the reaction. Of the reaction, student. And this is the rate of disappearance of A. This is the rate of disappearance of A, student. There is a difference between the two. Similarly, I can say rate of appearance of D. And rate of reaction is different. Rate of reaction, we have shown this is the rate of the reaction, student. And that is the rate of disappearance or rate of appearance. Sometimes questions are given on that. What is the rate expression or rate law, student? What is the rate expression or rate law, students?
Rate law is the expression in which the rate of the reaction is given in terms of the molar concentration of the reactants. Each term is raised to some power which may or may not be equal to the stoichiometric coefficient.
Therefore, for a general reaction, AA plus BB gives CC plus DD, we are saying rate is equal to some constant A power X, B power Y. X is called the order of the reaction with respect to A. And Y is the order of the reaction with respect to B, students. Total order of the reaction is X plus Y. And this is a determined experimentally, most important point. X and Y are determined experimentally. They are not theoretical values, students. They are not theoretical values. Important question will be asked on this. Important question will be asked on this, student, order of the reaction. What is the molecularity of a reaction, students?
Sir, your voice is breaking.
Which what is the molecularity of the reaction, students?
The molecularity, okay. The number of reacting species taking part in an elementary reaction, which must collide simultaneously in order to bring about the reaction.
What is the difference between order and molecularity? This question has been asked so many times, students. Order and molecularity difference is an important question they will ask you in the exam, students.
The order of a reaction is determined experimentally, and the molecularity of a reaction is a theoretical concept.
Can the molecularity be more than 3?
No, sir. Molecularity.
Why the higher order molecularities are not possible?
Because the probability that more than 3 molecules will collide and react simultaneously is very small.
Okay, what is a zero order reaction, students? R is equal to P. What we are saying, student, rate is equal to K R power 0. Rate is equal to K. So the rate is equal to the K value, students. That is a zero order reaction. Zero order reaction, students. So minus D of R by DT is equal to K, student. For zero order reaction, minus or dr is equal to k dt, student, for zero order reaction. And if I integrate, what I will get, student? If I integrate, student, d of r is equal to minus k of dt. If I integrate, students, between time 0 to time t, what will I get, student? R minus R of 0 is equal to minus k of t minus k of t. Students, r is the concentration at time t, r zero is the original concentration student. So what we get, r is equal to r naught zero plus k of t student. ठीक है?
Yes sir.
Therefore, what will be the value of k for this? R minus r of 0 divided by t. This is the original concept. R. This is minus kt. Some mistake is there. This is minus. Then what it will become? This will become r 0 minus r. The sign will be changed. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we can see what will be the value of the t half for zero order reaction. When half means, what will happen to t half student? This becomes r 0 by 2.
R 0 by 2.
So what will be the result of that?
R naught by 2k.
R naught
by 2k.
By 2k. Important formula. That means for zero order reaction, half-life is directly proportional to the concentration. Half-life is directly proportional to the concentration. Important equation, student. The numericals will be there on this. That's why we're doing it. First order reaction, student. What is the first order reaction? Minus d of r by dt is equal to k into r power 1, student. Minus dr by r will be equal to minus k dt if I make it plus, student. So integrate this. What will you get, student, between 0 and t? 0 and t. What you are getting, student? What formula you are getting in this? Minus kt will be equal to what, student? Ln of r by r0 is equal to kt, student. For first order reaction, what is the formula of the first order reaction which will be used in large number of numericals? Kt is equal to 2.303 log of
r naught by r.
Log of what, students?
Log of r naught by r.
R naught by r, there is a negative sign, then this is minus kt. ठीक है?
Yes.
So the reverse will be there. Kt is 2 log of r naught by r. So this is the concentration at time t equal to 0. This is the concentration, or sometimes we write this equation in more simple form, student. Kt is equal to r to p. If a is the original concentration, you writing after time, at time t, it becomes a minus x, it becomes x. And original concentration was a at t equal to 0. So what we get, student? Kt is equal to 2.303 log of a by a minus x. These are important formulas for solving questions and numericals. What will happen? What will be the half-life of this, student? First order reaction. Half-life of first order reaction.
0.693 upon k.
Question has been asked on this many. This will be used in numericals every time. Lot of numericals. These formulas are very important. One numerical is going to be there on first order 100%. Every year they are asking questions on that, student. We should be clear of that. So students, what we are talking, different type of reactions. This is just a small revision, and the type of reaction and the units of the zero order and first order will be asked in the paper. K units. What are the units of K, student, for zero order? we have given a general formula to calculate those values and units for first order and second order or any order. Is an important question is asked repeatedly in the paper. So what we are calculating, students, a lot of numericals are likely to be asked in this chapter, and effect of temperature is important. What is the effect of temperature, student? What is Arrhenius equation? Arrhenius equation, student, important. Here a lot of questions will come. K is equal to, this is an important, we can take the log of this and calculate the value of the rate constant. Ea is the activation energy, T is the temperature. These are some of the important formulas which will be asked student in the exam. You have noted all this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, there's something more. This is a complete revision as well as question answer session. So we should know where the questions are coming. We are aware where the questions are coming, students. We will be aware of that. K is equal to A E minus E A by R T. If I take the log of this, student, for if I have K1 and if I have K2, what will happen?
We'll subtract both the equations.
So what is the result of this, student? What formula we are getting for solving the most important numericals? Ln of K2 by K1 will be equal to, student,
Ea upon R,
Ea upon R
into 1 minus 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2.
Okay, T2 minus T1 divided by T1 into T2. So if I make this log, then I multiply this by 2.303. Important formula for the exam, student. Such questions are going to be there, student, and important graphs are likely to be there, student. Then there was a question, student, on what is Coulomb theory, students. What is Coulomb theory? When the reaction takes place, what happens? The molecules must collide
in order to bring about the reaction.
Well, will all Coulombs be effective, students?
No, sir.
No, sir. Then what is the requirement, student? The molecules should collide, and not only they should collide, but they should collide, student, with minimum of activation energy is required, student. So ZAB is the Coulomb frequency. Any reaction which is taking place, A plus B gives products, students. There has to be Coulomb between the molecules, and not all the Coulombs are effective. So what are the conditions for the reaction to take place? effective coulombs. What are effective coulombs, students? They must have energy.
Minimum activation energy.
Minimum activation energy or greater than this. Second condition, orientation factor, students. That molecules not only collide, student, they must collide with a proper orientation or the reaction may not take place, student. So what we call as a steric or what they call as probability factor. And this question was given why the rates are much less than the number of coulombs are very, very large, but the rates are less. So the equation is modified to take into account these type of things. What is activation energy, students? What is activation energy, students?
The activation energy is the minimum amount of threshold energy which is required to bring about the reaction.
All right. So let us see what type of questions could be asked in the paper, students. Once we know, then we must be prepared for question answer session. They are important type of questions which can be asked, student. For example, MCQ questions on chemical kinetics, student, chemical kinetics. Which of the following is affected by the catalyst, student? Which of the following is affected by the catalyst? You have delta H, delta S, delta G, and EA.
EA.
Activation energy, you know that when we add a catalyst, what the catalyst does?
It lowers the activation energy.
Catalyst lowers the energy of activation of any reaction. Important point, student. In the NCERT book, you will see a graph also of the activation energy graph. You have seen, student, reactants and products. And when you add a catalyst, what happens to this? E catalyzed. The activation energy becomes less, student. Energy versus reaction progress. That graph shows how it happens. The activation energy of a reaction can be determined from the slope of, students. This is an important point to note, student. The activation energy can be determined from the slope of, what was the Arrhenius equation? K is equal to A minus RT. So what is ln K? Ln of A minus EA by R 1 by T, students. Y is equal to MX plus C, students. So if I make a graph between Y axis and X axis, which I will make a graph of what?
It should be ln k versus 1 by t.
So this ln k versus 1 by t. Ln k versus 1 by t. So when I will make a graph of ln k versus 1 by t. Ln k versus, students, 1 by t. What will happen if this is 0? Then it will come equal to, it is a negative slope. It is a negative slope. So the graph which you make, student, what is the use of this graph? What is the use of this graph, students? Important. Graphs are asked many times, student, in the paper. So we should be aware of such graphs which will be there, student. Ln k, what is the nature of the graph, student? 1 by t 0, when 1 by t 0, what is ln k equal to? What values can be derived? Because this question will be there in the paper, but in different form. What is the use of this graph, students? What is this value? What I can get from this graph?
Its slope can help us determine the activation.
When
1
by t is equal to 0, ln k is equal to ln of a. Okay? And this is my intercept. And you can obtain from the intercept the value of a. Okay? If you want to calculate the value of a, I can get graphic method, student. This is my ln of a, this point. And what will happen, student? If I want to calculate the value of EA, how will I get the value of EA? This graph is used to determine the value of AA. How will you get? How to determine EA from this graph, students? Question has been given in numerical also. How to determine EA? What is the slope of this? What will be the slope of this?
EA by 2.303.
Minus, I am saying.
Minus E upon
2.303 R. So from this, if I calculate the value of the slope, students, what is slope? Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus X1. If I calculate the value of this slope, then I can calculate the value of activation energy. A numerical has been given in the paper 2-3 years back. See the question which is there. There could be variation in the question in the exam. Many questions can be put up. It is not that I am just giving you this. So this is a question in the paper question from this 5-7 questions we have prepared from these students. So we should be aware of what we are doing. That is our point, student. Next question is coming on the screen, student. The half-life period of first order reaction is 1386 seconds. The specific rate constant of the reaction is. Some calculation is involved, student. You have 1 to 2 minutes to answer the question, student. So we should be aware of the formulas which we have given, and these formulas will be used constantly and continuously to answer the question, students. Half life is how much? 1386 second. What is the formula?
T half is equal to 0.693 upon K.
First order reaction.
0.693 upon K.
T half is equal to 0.693 by K. Then what is the answer coming, students?
It is coming as 0.5 into 10 raised to power minus 3.
0.693 by T half.
0.693
by 1386. 1386, student. That is cancelling actually.
Yes, sir. So it is coming out as B.
Power 2. So what is that? 1 by 2?
Point, yes, sir. 0.5 into 10 raised to power minus 3.
0.5 into 10 raised to power minus 3, student.
B.
What are the units?
Per second.
Okay. Okay. Which answer is correct?
B.
B answer. So some, not a very large calculation, but once we know that we will have to make calculations, we will have to make graph, student, and then he will ask you to calculate slope or activation energy. Activation energy, student. If the initial concentration of reactant is doubled, T half is also doubled, the order of the reaction is 0, 1, 2, 3, students.
1.
One answer is wrong. First, why? How you will answer the question without knowing what you are doing? He is saying initial concentration of reactant is doubled. T half. What is the formula of T half for zero order, student? Tell me.
For zero order it is R naught by 2k.
If reaction is R into P student, this R naught by
2k.
2k. And what is the T half for first order reaction students?
0.693 upon k.
This is a constant then. K. What is this? This 1 by 2k is a constant. Then you have R0. So, if I change the concentration here, what happens to half life? There is no concentration here. Any
zero,
concentration term?
It should be A option.
So, it does not depend on concentration. Which one? First order.
First order.
And zero order, T half is directly proportional to concentration. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So if I double it, then which will be doubled? This zero order.
Zero order.
So don't answer any question without going into the complete detail, student, important question. I will be in trouble myself. I will do a mistake. If concentration of reactant A is increased 10 times, the rate of reaction becomes 100 times. What is the order with respect to A? Reaction is taking place, student, A to B. R is equal to K A power X. Okay? Now
yes,
he is
sir.
Saying R1, supposing then R2 is equal to K. It is increased 10 times. ठीक है 10 टाइम्स 10 ए पावर एक्स हाउ मच इट बिकम्स 100 आर वन देन व्हाट इज द ऑर्डर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ए स्टूडेंट्स आर टू बाई आर वन हाउ मच हंड्रेड
इट शुड बी
के Then what is this? K 10 A power X divided by K. What is this? A power X. K will cancel student.
It should be 2.
10 power X.
2.
100 is equal to 10 power x.
X. X
and
is
the
equal
scale
to
is equal to 10 power x. So then x is equal to 2.
2.
Where is the 2 answer?
I think some
mistake is there.
Two options are same here. Yes, sir.
Okay. Changing the question. Then this will be the answer. Without doing, there will be some problem. So we must be try to answer a question, student, by doing it. By doing, the answer comes which we are confident, then we can answer correctly. Consider the Arrhenius equation given below and mark the correct option, students. K is equal to A E minus R T. This is our Arrhenius equation. The rate constant increases exponentially with increasing activation energy and decreasing temperature. Rate constant, this K is rate constant, in increases exponentially with increasing activation energy.
This is wrong.
Rate constant decreases exponentially with increasing activation energy and decreasing temperature. Think about it. Next question. Rate constant increases exponentially with a decreasing activation energy and decreasing temperature.
It is wrong.
Rate constant increasing exponentially with decreasing activation energy.
Increases. D is correct.
के इज इक्वल टू ए ई माइनस, दिस इज नेगेटिव स्टूडेंट्स, माइनस ई ए बाई आर टी. इफ द टी बिकम्स, दिस इज नेगेटिव वैल्यू, नेगेटिव वैल्यू स्टूडेंट, इज नॉट पॉजिटिव. सो इफ ई ए, दिस इज माई एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी, इट बिकम्स लार्ज, देन इट बिकम्स मोर नेगेटिव, लेस. सो ई ए डिक्रीजिस, वन पॉइंट इज क्लियर.
यस
इफ
सर,
ई ए बिकम्स लेस, के विल बिकम मोर. यस. एंड
यस सर,
सेकेंड पॉइंट, दिस ई ए इज नेगेटिव इफ इफ टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजिस, टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजिस, देन इट विल बी, दिस होल फैक्टर विल बिकम लेस. दैट मीन्स दिस हैज
ओके
इंक्रीज्ड. इफ टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजेस स्टूडेंट, इफ आई इंक्रीज दिस, दिस वैल्यू बिकम्स, व्हाट हैपेंस टू दिस, दिस इज नेगेटिव वैल्यू, नेगेटिव वैल्यू स्टूडेंट्स. सो दिस इज मोर, दिस इज लेस नेगेटिव. सो लेस नेगेटिव मीन्स के मोर,
यस
लेस
सर,
नेगेटिव,
यस सर,
देन के इंक्रीजेस. इफ टी इंक्रीजेस, के इंक्रीजेस. सो वट विल हैपन, वट इज द आंसर देन? ई ए डिक्रीजेज एंड टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजेस, विच चॉइस इज दैट? डिक्रीजिंग एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी एंड इंक्रीजिंग टेम्परेचर, वेयर इज दैट?
डी
ओके, सी दैट इट समटाइम्स इज वेरी ट्रिकी एंड वी हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल एंड अलर्ट. पे अटेंशन, पे अटेंशन. वी हैव टू थिंक अलॉट बिफोर वी आंसर द क्वेश्चन, बिकॉज ये सर्टेन सर्ट क्वेश्चन कुड बी गिवन इन असर्शन एंड रीजनिंग, बिकॉज विदाउट थिंकिंग आई कैन नॉट आंसर एनी क्वेश्चन. असर्शन एंड रीजनिंग आर ऑल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट, दे हेल्प अ स्टूडेंट बिकॉज टू लर्न मोर एंड मोर थिंग्स. ए फर्स्ट ऑर्डर रिएक्शन इज 50% कंप्लीटेड इन 1.26, एक्चुअली दिट इज 1.26 10 पावर 14
14.
सेकेंड्स. 50% कंप्लीटेड इन दैट मच, हाउ मच टाइम वुड इट टेक फॉर 100% कंप्लीशन? कंप्लीशन स्टूडेंट, हाउ मच टाइम इट विल टेक स्टूडेंट? दीज आर 10 पावर्स, 15, 10 पावर 14, 1.26, 10 पावर 15 सेकेंड्स, 2.52. के यू कैन मेक द कैलकुलेशंस टू आंसर द क्वेश्चन स्टूडेंट्स. व्हाट इज योर आंसर कमिंग?
सर, इट इज कमिंग टू बी इनफाइनाइट.
What is the formula for the first order student?
फर्स्ट ऑर्डर 0.693 अपॉन के.
If I say 100% student, what it means? 100% reaction means R goes to P. 100% means there is a zero of this.
यस सर,
What is left? Zero.
यस सर,
If I say that this is zero, then what is the value coming?
इट विल बी 0 इनफाइनाइट.
So the value is infinite. It is an important point, student,
यस
because
सर,
zero, the first order reaction will, the concentration will never become zero. ठीक है? It will never, first order reaction, important point. Is never 100% complete. Very important point, students. What about the zero order reaction, student? the zero order reaction will become 100%.
Yes, it can complete.
It can complete, student. Zero order reaction can complete, but first order reaction cannot, because all the radioactive decay, all the radioactive decay, what type of reactions they are?
First order.
First order. And they, these radioactive isotopes never end. They never finish, student. The concentration keep on decreasing, half, half, half. But they will never be zero. Any radioactive element, the Hiroshima atomic bomb explosions, if radioactive elements were there, what happened, students? Their concentration will never become zero, but will keep on reducing. So they may come to a very, very low, low, low level, but they will never be zero. So whatever radioactive isotopes you have on planet Earth, they are decreasing, they are decaying, but half of half life, that's why we give their half life, student. We give the half life of radioactive isotopes. Did we ever say full life of radioactive isotope? The answer is no. The concentration is decreasing. How much time it will take? Half, 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 and it will never be zero. That's important point. Whereas the zero order reactions can become, student, 100% complete. First order reaction is never 100% complete. That was the reason question was given. Most of the students didn't know about it. They were answering some other part of the question. Activation energy of a chemical reaction can be determined. Determining the rate constant at standard temperature, determining the rate constant at room temperature, determining probability of collision using catalyst. How do you determine the activation energy of a chemical reaction, students?
Determining the rate constants at two different temperatures.
Because we have just shown you K. Arrhenius equation is very important. At any question can be asked on this, student. Arrhenius equation. What was the formula? Log of K2 by K1?
K1 is equal to EA by 2.303 RT R into 1 by T1 minus 1 by T.
T2 minus T1 by T1 into T2. Okay. This is the way we determine activation energy. EA can be determined, student. There is a graphic method also, we have told you. By graph, we told you, student.
Yes,
ln of K is equal to ln of A minus EA by RT. So if I make a graph of ln K versus 1 by T, then what happens, student? What will be the slope? Minus EA by R. This is important. Question has been asked on this. So depends on what question is given. Numerical has been given by this type of graph was given, and students were asked to find it. Such a question can be asked in your exams. Therefore, student, you should be aware of all possibilities. When we write a question, we are writing one question. There could be many questions similar to that. Variation in question is very important. The rate of a certain hypothetical reaction is given as this, student. Given rate is equal to minus dAbt is equal to k a half b half c. The order of the reaction is, what is the order of this reaction? What is the order of the reaction, student?
1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4.
How much it will come, student?
It is D, 13 by 12. 12.
2, 6, the 3, 4, the 4, 3, the how much is that?
13 by 12, D.
13 by 12. Order of a reaction. 13 by 12. I mean, this we already know, but sometimes they will give you numbers, students, just to see whether students are cramming or they know how to do it. Because a lot of students are not understanding. They are not understanding the subject, student, what they are doing, just cramming the things, and they are in trouble. For the reaction N2N2, if NH3 is equal to 2, tell me the value of minus delta H by delta 2 would be. this question has been given in CBSE sample paper. I mean, was given in one of the papers.
It will be 3 into 10 key power minus 4.
Let us see, student, how will we solve this question? I am saying the rate of the reaction can be written as minus delta of N2 by delta T is equal to minus 1 by 3 delta of hydrogen change in molar concentration divided by delta T is equal to, students, 1 by 2 delta NH3. And numerical was given, actually. If I can write this, then it will become easier for me to solve it. Any, what is given to me, students? Delta NH3. So that means what I am given, I can write it like this, minus 1 by 3 delta H2 by delta T is equal to 1 by 2. What is the value of delta NH3 by into 2 into 10 minus 4 mole liter S inverse? That is the given value. Yes, what sir. I want to find, minus delta H2 by delta T, student. How much it will be then? 3 by 2 into 2 into 10 minus 4.
Three.
Mole liter. Any answer?
3 into 10 key power minus 4, B.
Which answer is that? B1?
B.
Okay. This is an important point I told you earlier also, when we write the rate and rate of disappearance or appearance of the two things are different. In a numerical, they ask this question. Okay. For a chemical reaction A to B, students, it is found the rate of reaction doubles when the concentration of A is increased 4 times. Or 1 is equal to k a power x. Rate of reaction doubles when the concentration of A is increased 4 times. 4a. What is the value of x then, students? Order of a reaction. Two of R1 by R1 is equal to, will cancel, student, A will cancel, 4 the power X. What is that?
Will be 1 by 2. 2X, 2.
2 power 1 is 2, and 2 power x. Oh, we are writing something else. 2. This is our 2 power 2 the square.
It should be.
ठीक है? 2 the square.
Yes, sir.
What was that? A is increased 4 times. A is increased. The order of the reaction is. ठीक है, 4 power x I can write as 2 is equal to 4 power x.
4 power x.
What it means?
X should be 1 by 2.
That means 2 the power 2x. 2 the power 2x. ठीक है?
Yes, sir.
Implies 2 the square to the power 2x is 1, then 2x is equal to 1, then x is equal to 1 by 2. What is the answer coming? Half?
Half.
Okay. Just sometimes we have to be sure that the maths involved is not very big, but small amount of mass is involved. Students, what will be the fraction of molecules having energy equal to or greater than activation energy? This is given by the Arrhenius equation, student. Arrhenius equation. What is Arrhenius equation, student? K is equal to A E minus E A by R T, students. A is called Arrhenius constant. And what is the fraction of molecules having energy equal to or greater than activation energy, students?
It will be D, EA upon RT.
This is Arrhenius vector. This is the fraction of the molecules which have energy equal to or greater than activation energy. The fraction of molecules. Fraction of molecules having energy equal to or greater than activation energy. EA by RT, students, which is answer then? D is the correct answer. This question was put up in the paper and is important question. Next question on the screen, student. What type of reaction is this, student? Second order, unimolecular, pseudo unimolecular, third order,
pseudo unimolecular.
This is a hydrolysis of an ester, student.
Yes, sir.
And you know hydrolysis of ester, student. And this reagent is in large excess. Water is present in large excess, therefore it will behave like a pseudo first order reaction. Pseudo unimolecular or pseudo first order reaction, student. Important. Hydrolysis of ester is an example given in your NCERT book also. Similar type of questions have been put up in the paper in a different way. Next question is coming. Which of the following is a false statement, student? Rate of zero order reaction is independent of initial concentration of reactant. Half life of a third order reaction is inversely proportional to square of the initial concentration. Molecularity of a reaction may be zero or a fraction. For a first order reaction, T half is equal to 0.693 by K.
Yes, sir.
Which is a false?
C.
See. What about A? What is A? Zero order is independent of initial concentration. Rate of a zero order, that is
correct.
Half life of a third order reaction inversely proportional to square, although it is not in our course, but this molecularity of a reaction may be zero or fraction. No.
This is false. Yes, sir.
And this is correct for zero, first order. True. So, C answer is there, students. Therefore, student, these are some of the questions which can be asked in the chemical kinetics. Our purpose was to just revise the physical chemistry as well as solve certain questions which can be given, or the questions can be changed or varied, so that we know how to think and solve the questions. Okay, then we will see you in the next class and continue more and more topics we have to discuss and see what type of questions have been asked in the previous papers and what can be asked this year. Whether it's MCQ form or same question, I can put in reasoning assertive forms, same question I can ask directly in the statement form. I mean, it depends. So questions, how they will be asked, graphs will be asked, all this is possible. All right, then we'll see you in the next class.
Okay, thank you, sir.